Hello and welcome back to the channel. On today's episode, as discussed on the episode of Helping Tuesday, there will be I'll be discussing the FA Cup final as a preview today. Give my personal opinions for once on what I think the result will be. Maybe those scorers, whatever. But with it being on Saturday or Sunday, a 5:30 kickoff, I'm pretty sure it is. Probably should have read this up. I've got the knowledge of it before, but it's Arsenal v Chelsea, a North London derby it is, in the FA Cup final. There's a chance for the Manchester derby to happen, but both Manchester clubs did mess up. As you can see, I'm not wearing my jumper as I usually do today because it is about 25 degrees, so it is quite warm. With it being back to the FA Cup, discussions there about me. It's going to be an interesting game as both teams have been a bit stop-start since the restart. In the last five games, both Arsenal and Chelsea have won three games and both lost two of the last five. Arsenal have scored 8 goals in the last five games, conceding 6. Chelsea have scored 9 goals in the last 5 games, which is obviously just one there, but they have conceded 3 more in 9. So, with it being that, Arsenal scoring 8, conceding 6, Chelsea scoring and conceding 9 in the last 5 games, it's not really, they're both coming to it off the back of wins on the final day of the Premier League season. Confidence, really, it's got to be a mix-up between it, because with this season, it's been better season for Chelsea getting the top four with Frank Lampard, finishing fourth, just, and Arsenal, we did have Unai Emery until I think it was October, November time, and they sacked him. Had Lundberg for a few games and then they appointed to make Arteta, which he has done better to transform them into a team that's playing that kind of tiki-taka football with better defensive performances. With it, for me personally, with recent performances, both done very well in the FA Cup semi-final, both Arsenal against Man City winning 2-0. And Chelsea winning 3-1 against Manchester United. Both are can be very dodgy at the back, but can be very solid and very good in the attack, but can be a bit poor. With it will be an interesting game on Sunday, with both teams going between a 3-4-3 and almost like a 4-2-3-1. It will generally be whose defence is better, because as you know, you people really know, both Mustafi and David Luiz could start for Arsenal and it could be very shocking. But Rudiger for Chelsea, Kurt Zouma and Christensen could start for Chelsea and that could be very dodgy. This season for both teams has been very poor defensively for both teams. And not the best attacking wise, even though they are scoring a good amount of goals. You did have a Aubameyang finish, I think, running up in the Golden Boot with 22 goals. With our top goal scorer, Chelsea's top goal scorer, I think, was Tammy Abraham with 17. This is just in the Premier League, I don't know overall competitions. But with it being that it'll be hard to kind of guess, because both teams play a kind of different style of football, but almost a similar style. It's got to be whoever wins, either Mikel Arteta or Frank Lampard, it's going to be the first trophy in managerial positions. Just as a manager, whoever comes out with the win on Sunday will be FA Cup winners in will have the first trophy as a manager in the in their portfolio. So, but with that, it's like, for me personally, I think it will be Chelsea. I think Chelsea will do it. Also, because I think there'll be a bit of pressure on the team, especially with the front three. With Chelsea signing Hakim Ziyech, Ajax for about 40 million, and Timo Werner for Leipzig for about 60 million, there will be pressure on Olivier Giroud, Tammy Abraham, Mason Mount, Callum Hudson-Odoi, Pulisic, to kind of fight for their place for next season, and us with the Premier season do kicking off 12th of September. It's going to be a good scrap with the game. Both teams will want it there, because Arsenal need to win or they will not have any European football for next season. After finishing 10th, I think it was. Or it might have been 8th. 8th, actually, I think it was. It is generally, Arsenal will need to win or to even have European football. At best, it will be as Europa League. I think it'll just be Europa League qualifiers, I don't think it's group stages. So if it is, Arsenal will be first and worth games at the start of September with qualifiers before they kick off a new season. With it being this, Arsenal haven't made a signing yet, even though there's links of saying that Pablo Mari, they're on loan for Fluminense, I think it is, on a permanent deal from its loan. I don't know. There's links with Upamecano for Leipzig, but he has just recently signed a new deal, a new 3-year contract, seeing him till the 2023. Personally, I would say it'll be Chelsea. I think they're a stronger team for next season, especially with the pressure they'll have on the front three with the youngsters. It being linked with Kai Havertz, it's got almost spot on Chelsea to try and get with the youngsters to make sure that they'll be in contention for starting next season. With Timo Werner scoring, I think, 30 plus goals this season overall. Even Ziyech has created about 20 plus goals this season. With Arsenal's dodgy defending, I'm personally going to say I'll say 3-1 Chelsea. I'll stick out there. It'll be 3-1 Chelsea. It will be Frank Lampard's FA Cup, his first trophy in management for me personally. It is hard to call because they are similarly matched teams, even though they finished about four places, I think it is, a difference in the Premier League. But to be honest, I think I've been more impressed with Chelsea this season because the way they're playing, it is nice football to watch. Arteta, next season, I think Arsenal will be back challenging for a top 6 spot, but all depends on the transfers. But with that, I think I've got a pretty good verdict. I'm saying 3-1 Chelsea, 3-1 Chelsea in the FA Cup final on Sunday at 5:30. Monday's episode will be a review of the FA Cup. Yep, it will be a review of the FA Cup, as long as the weather treats me nicely. That's why the video on Monday went up on Tuesday instead of thinking, because for the full day I was chucking it down with rain. I couldn't get out and record the video. Could have done it in my house, but I was always going to be that busy. But with that, hopefully Monday will be a good day. Hopefully the FA Cup final on Sunday will be a very good match. for both teams. Probably be good, high pressing, entertaining football to watch. But yeah, I think with that, I can wrap it up here. But before you go, drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, share it with all your friends, family, friends, everyone you can. Let's try and press it out to as many people as possible. There will be a link in the description for the official Twitter account. As again, please go over there, drop a follow on the account. Be very much appreciated. Drop a comment on what you... Drop a comment on what you think will be the result on Sunday, and who do you think will win the FA Cup 2019-20 FA Cup, the longest FA Cup in history. With that, catch you all later.